Pakistan is set to hold its general elections from July 25th. Now, Pakistan has spent more than 30 years under military's rule, which is why its democracy does not have a strong root and military continues to have a big impact. The country experienced its first ever democratic full term of power after 66 years of independence in 2013 when Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz won the general elections, making it the biggest party. Interestingly, the religious parties in Pakistan, including the banned JUD, have fielded more than 460 candidates in the elections this year, breaking all grounds. The Parliament of Pakistan is a bicameral federal legislature, which includes a Senate and a National Assembly. The National Assembly consists of 342 seats, out of which 70 are reserved for women and non-Muslims, which are then allocated to the parties according to their performances in the polls. Now, to have a majority, a party or a coalition must have at least 172 seats or 50% of the total number. Pakistan has four major political parties: Bilawal Bhutto's Pakistan People's Party, Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf, Shehbaz Sharif's Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz, and MQM, headed by Altaf Hussain and Farooq Sattar. Pakistan People's Party, founded in 1967, has a strong hold in the southern Sindh province. Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf, founded in 1996, has a majority in Pakhtun area. Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz has a strong hold in the Punjab province, where it has made a government for six times. MQM has a strong hold in Karachi. Now, any party which leads in Punjab leads the country because of the high number of seats in the Punjab province, which is why Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz has made a government for the most number of times. Now, in this year's general elections, the number of seats up for grabs in the Punjab province are 141, followed by Sindh with 61 seats, Pakhtun with 39 seats, Balochistan with 16 seats, and federally administered tribal areas with 12 seats. Now, the recently released pre-election polls showed PML-N was the most preferred party in the largest province, but PTI was not far behind. So it'll be interesting to see which party actually takes the lead. Watch this space for more information on the Pakistan general elections.